Hey folks, welcome to Digimento Education. Welcome to yet another interesting video lecture on Engineering Mathematics. This is Engineering Mathematics Lecture 5. I'm your course instructor, Utkarsh Upadhyay. Hopefully you're all doing great and continuously revising the concepts that I covered in the last 4 lectures. If you haven't gone through them yet, I advise you to go through them first and then hop onto this video. The concepts that I had covered and will be covering in the subsequent lectures are very, very important. So it is highly advised, it is highly required for you to pay keen attention to what I'm going to teach and what I was teaching. Okay, let's begin this lecture. If you really like the video, please hit the like button, share and subscribe to our channel and write down your comments below in the comment section. If you have any doubts, please write them down in the comment section below and we shall surely get back to you with the solutions. Or else, if required, we could make a separate video on that. Okay? So, in the last lecture, we basically ended our discussion on homogeneous and non-homogeneous system of equations. I saw some gate examples based on the concepts that I covered in the last lecture. And hopefully, it basically increased your understanding, improved your understanding of the concepts that I covered in the last lecture. In this lecture, I am starting off with one of the most important topics of linear algebra, and you can surely expect the questions from this particular topic in the gate or any other competitive examinations that you will face in 2019. Those concepts are basically eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a matrix. So let's start with that. Eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay. So let us start with the basic definitions of eigenvalues and eigenvectors, because it is very, very important to know the definitions before jumping on the numericals. Okay. So let A be a matrix Aij of order n cross n, let's say square matrix, okay, be any n rowed square matrix, be a square matrix, okay, and let's say lambda, that is basically we will define it as an eigenvalue, lambda is a scalar, okay, A is a metric and lambda is a scalar, then the equation Ax is equal to lambda x. Ax is equal to lambda x is called the eigenvalue problem. Okay. This is basically your eigenvalue problem. So we basically wish to find out non-zero solution to x satisfying the eigenvalue problem. So we find non-zero solutions to x that satisfying eigenvalue problem. Okay. So, and these non-zero solution to x are called the eigenvectors, and these non-zero solutions of x are called eigenvectors. Okay, and the corresponding lambda values are called eigenvalues. Okay, are called eigenvalues. So, and of the A matrix, we define one more matrix which is A minus lambda I. So the matrix A minus lambda I is called as characteristic matrix of A. Characteristic matrix of A. Understood? Where I is a identity matrix. of order n. And A needs to be a square matrix, okay? This only exists for a square matrix. So also the determinant, we define one more term, determinant of A minus lambda I. This is defined, for example, you will have A11 minus lambda, A12, and so on and so forth up to A1n. Then we have A21, A22 minus lambda up to A2n. Up to an1, an2, up to ann minus lambda. We define this determinant, and this determinant is known as a characteristic polynomial of A. Okay, so this determinant is the characteristic polynomial of A in lambda. Polynomial of A in lambda. Okay, and the equation determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0 is called as characteristic equation of A. Okay, so there is a very subtle difference between the polynomial and the equation of A. If it is equated to 0, this becomes an equation. Okay, and the roots of this equation are the characteristic roots of A. Okay, characteristic roots of or characteristic values or latent roots or proper values or eigenvalues. Okay, of A. So this is, these terms are basically used interchangeably. Whenever you encounter one of these terminologies in the question paper, in the question, then it is quite tacit, it will be quite tacit for you to understand that the question is talking about the eigenvalues of A. And you need to find out the eigenvalues of A. Hopefully you have basically, you have already ran across this particular equation when you studied the control systems. So when you, or when you, so in this case, we in the control system, we define Q of S, a determinant of Si minus A minus Si or Si minus A, Si minus A determinant. This is basically the characteristic equation of the system, of the closed loop system. Si minus A is basically comes in the denominator of the closed loop transfer function. Okay, this is the characteristic equation which we represent by Q of S. Determinant of this thing will be a characteristic equation. That's something which will be covered in control system. Okay, and that's basically, that's why I'm trying to establish the similarity between the two, maths and control system. So there is no difference between the two. Okay, and the set of the eigenvalues of A, the set of eigenvalues of A is called spectrum of A. Okay, this is called as the spectrum of A. We also define a characteristic vector. Just like the characteristic values, we define the characteristic vector, which are the eigenvectors. So if lambda is a characteristic root of an n cross n A matrix A, then non-zero vector X such that AX is equal to lambda X is called characteristic vector or eigenvector of A corresponding to the characteristic root lambda. So whenever you will define the characteristic roots or the eigenvalues of a matrix A, there will be a corresponding eigenvector. Okay, so let's begin with some examples based on this of finding out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and then again we shall dive deep into some more concepts. Okay, let's have a look at this particular example. The smallest and the largest eigenvalues of the following matrices respectively are, for this is a matrix, so which among the following options is correct. So for finding out the eigenvalue, let's write the characteristic equation. So we have the characteristic equation, A minus lambda I is equal to 0. So if we just write it here, you get 3 minus 2, 2, 4 minus 4, 6, 2 minus 3, 5 minus determinant of that minus lambda times of 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, this is basically a matrix inside, and then we need to find out the determinant. Okay, is equal to 0. You get the determinant of 3 minus lambda minus 2, 2, 4 minus 4 minus lambda, 6. Then we have 2 minus 3, 5 minus lambda. Determinant of this thing will be equal to 0. If we open this thing up, you get 3 minus lambda times minus 20 plus 4 lambda minus 5 lambda plus lambda square plus 18 plus 2 times of 20 minus 4 lambda minus 12 plus 2 minus 12 plus 8 plus 2 lambda is equal to 0. You get, on solving, you get lambda cube minus 4 lambda square plus 5 lambda minus 2 equal to 0. Since it is a cubic equation, first of all you have to basically guess root of this thing which satisfies this equation. So if lambda is equal to 1, this equation satisfies. So we get three different roots. If you solve for this, you get lambda is equal to 1, 1 and 2. So you can say the smallest eigenvalue, is 1, and largest eigenvalue is 2. So the answer will be 1 and 2, which is the D. So D option is correct. Let's have a look at another example. Now let's have a look at this example. Which of the following is an eigenvector of the matrix? This. So these are the eigenvectors which are given to us. First of all, we need to find out the eigenvalues. Okay, so for that we need to construct the characteristic equation, which is basically equal to 5 minus lambda. This will be 0, 0, 0. 0, 5 minus lambda, 0. It will be 5, 0. 0, 0, 2 minus lambda, 1. And 0, 0, 3, 1 minus lambda. So opening up this determinant is pretty simple. It will be 5 minus lambda into 5 minus lambda, 5 minus lambda, 5 minus lambda, 2 minus lambda into 1 minus lambda minus 3. This will be equal to 2 minus lambda into 1 minus lambda minus 3 is equal to 0. If you open this thing up, you get 5 minus lambda, lambda square minus 3 lambda minus 1 equal to 0. If you solve this equation, you get four different roots that come out to be lambda is equal to 5, 3 plus minus root 13 by 2. So there are these four roots which are available to us. Okay. Now we need to find out corresponding to each eigenvalue, we need to find out the eigenvectors, and we have to check for the options. Okay. Let's say let lambda is equal to 5. Okay. Let lambda is equal to 5 in A minus lambda I x is equal to 0 or Ax is equal to lambda x. We generally go by this. Okay. Now this is matrix, this is not a determinant, okay? A minus lambda I x, as I already told you. Okay, this will be equal to 5 minus 5, lambda is equal to 5, it will be 5 minus 5, 0, 0, 0. 0, 5, minus 5, 5, 0, 0, 0, 2, minus 5, 2, minus 5, 1, and 0, 0, 3, 1, minus 5. Now, this will be equal to x1, x2, x3, and x4 is equal to 0. What are we left with is this, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 5, 0, 0, 0, minus 3, 1, 0, 0, 3, minus 4. Okay, x1, x2, x3, and x4. Okay, now if we just try to write the equations in terms of x1, x2, x3, and x4, we get one equation as 3x, so we one equation we get is minus 3x plus x4 is equal to 0. Okay, minus 3x plus x4 is equal to 0. Another equation is 3x minus 3x3 minus 4x4. We get 3x3 minus 4x4 is equal to 0. Okay, we also get 5x3 is equal to 0. And so these are the equations that we can get. From here we can say x3 is equal to 0. If we put it here, we get x4 is equal to 0. Okay, so this equation satisfies. So and x1 and x2, since we do not know anything about x1 x2, x1 and x2 can take any value. Okay, they can take any value, but it is confirmed that x4 and x3 are 0. So your eigenvector x1, x2, x3 and x4 is of the form, so let's say x1 can take the value k1 and x2 can take the value k2, where k1 and k2 belong to some real number. Okay, so this will be equal to this, these two will be always 0, and this will be k1 and k2. Okay, where so since choice a, so abhiya, let us just have a quick look at that. So there are only two, there is only one option which is basically satisfies the given condition. We have this, so since only one option can be correct, so you can see the x3 and x4 are 0, 0 respectively. So A option basically is satisfying the answer. Here you can see that A option is satisfying the answer. Okay. So since we basically, since it is basically single choice correct question, and since we have got an eigenvector for lambda is equal to 5, so there is no need to find out the eigenvector corresponding to 5 plus minus root 13 by 2. Which is this, so we don't need to find out 3 plus minus root 13 by 2, we don't need to find out the eigenvector. Had it been a multiple choice, multi correct answer, then we would have certainly, we would be required to find out the eigenvector corresponding to this particular eigenvalue, these two eigenvalues. Okay, now let's have a look at another question. Now, the number of linearly independent eigenvectors of the matrix this are. The other options is asked for, this was asked in Mechanical Engineering GATE 2007 paper. Now it's quite clear from the given question that the matrix given to us is basically an upper triangular matrix. And basically the eigenvalues of an upper triangular matrix are its principal diagonal elements. I will basically summarize all the important concepts regarding the eigenvalues and eigenvectors once I am finished, once I am done with some examples to now to explain what are the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Till then, we find so the eigenvalues clearly are 2 and 2, so you know, 2 eigenvectors which are 2. So let me just, since I have not written them down in a concrete manner, so I am going to derive for you with the help of the characteristic equation. Since we know that we have the matrix 0, 1 and 0, 2, which is upper triangular matrix, so if we just form a characteristic equation, A minus lambda is equal to 0, we get 2 minus lambda 0, 0, sorry, this is 1, and this is 2 minus lambda is equal to 0. So from here, we get 2 minus lambda square minus 0 is equal to 0, okay. So from here, we can say lambda is equal to 2 and 2. So you can see that the answer comes out to be lambda is equal to 2 and 2. So since there is only one eigenvector, we can say, let's say put lambda is equal to 2 in A minus lambda I x is equal to 0. So we need to find out how many linearly independent eigenvectors of this matrix are there. Okay. So this matrix will become 2 minus lambda 1 0 2 minus lambda is equal to 0. Now if we just put lambda is equal to this thing, if it come out to be 0 1 0 0 x is equal to 0. Okay, now if you just open this thing up, you get x1 and x2. Okay, so from here it is clear that x2 is equal to 0. Okay, and if you just open along this, if you just open along this, 0x1 plus x2 is equal to 0 and 0x1 plus 0x2 is equal to 0. So here we can say x1 can be anything, can be any value. Okay, since we do not know, since we do not have a concrete answer what value that x1 would what value x1 will take, so that can take any value. Let's say it's equal to k, which belongs to any real, which can be any real number. Okay, since we have the concrete information about x2, which means which basically is zero always, so we have this. So eigenvector corresponding to this, eigenvector corresponding to this will be equal to x1 and x2, where x1 can be k and this is 0 and k times of 1 0. So since we need to find out the how many linearly independent eigenvectors are there for this, so there is only one linearly independent eigenvector. So you can see there is only one linearly independent eigenvector. Okay, they cannot be 2, they cannot be 3, and they cannot be infinite. So there is only one linearly independent eigenvector. So B is the answer for that. Let's have a look at another example. Let's draw our attention to this particular question. One of the eigenvectors of the matrix this A is, this was a mechanical engineering gate 2010 paper, and this was of 2 marks. So first of all, first thing first, this matrix is given to us. We need to find out the eigenvalues corresponding to that. So we make the characteristic equation. So this will be equal to 2 minus lambda, determinant of 2 minus lambda, 2, 1, 3 minus lambda should be equal to 0. If you solve for this, you get 2 minus lambda, 3 minus lambda, minus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, you get the equation as we solve for this, lambda square minus 5 lambda plus 4 is equal to 0. Solve for this, lambda is equal to 1 and 4. There are two eigenvalues which are basically now available to us. Okay, now we need to find out the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda is equal to 1 and lambda is equal to 4. Okay, understood. So let's basically write this equation is equal to 0. Let's say this is the eigenvector equation. So this will be equal to a minus lambda I, which is 2 minus lambda, 2, 1, 3 minus lambda. This will be equal to x1 and x2 is equal to 0 and 0. Now put lambda is equal to 1. Let's find out corresponding to lambda is equal to 1. You get 1, 2, 1, 2. You get 1, 2 and 1, 2. That's x1 and x2. So you can see that there exists a linear dependency of one row over another. So we can say, since there is a dependency, we can basically use a row, elementary row operation to cancel this thing up. So the rank of this matrix, as discussed earlier, if there exists a linear dependency in the matrix, then the determinant of that particular matrix will always be 0, which means that the rank of this matrix will not be 2, it will be less than 2, which in this case is 1. Nullity in this matrix will exist. So if we apply R2 minus R1, so we get the reduced echelon form, or you can say for the non-trivial solutions, we get for the non-trivial solutions, this will be equal to 0 and 0. 1, 2, we just need to subtract the 2. Okay, so from here we get x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 0. We do not have any information about x1 or x2 because both are satisfying this. Let's say x2 is equal to k. This implies that x1 will be equal to minus 2k. Okay, x2 is equal to k. Okay, so it will have non-trivial solutions in n minus r independent variables. which in this case n is 2 minus r is 1, rank is 1. There's only one independent variable. In this case, we have considered x2 as k is an independent variable and x1 is depending on that. Okay? There's only one independent variable. So we get the eigenvector. We get the eigenvector of the form minus 2k and 2k and k. Okay? So that is, we can say that k times of minus 2 and 1. So k can take basically any value. K can take any value. So if we just see the options, if we just have a look at the options, it basically comes turns out that 2 minus 1 can be one of the answers, because if we take k as minus 1, let k is equal to minus 1. So we get the eigenvector as 2 and minus 1. So from here, we can say that A is basically satisfying the above two conditions. 2 and 1 cannot be the answer. 4 and 1 cannot be the answer. 1 and minus 1 can never be the answer. Okay. If we just take k as 2, then the answer would have been 4 and 2. Okay. Since there is only one option, it's a basically single choice correct answer. So single choice, single answer correct. So we can say that 2 and minus 1 satisfies the given condition. So there is no need to find out the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda is equal to 4. Okay. If needed, you can easily find out. There's no problem. So A will be the answer. Let's have a look at another question. So for the matrix A, this matrix, one of the eigenvalues is minus 2. Which of the following is an eigenvector? So they are the options given to us. Now, as I already told you it's basically an upper triangular matrix, as you can see. And the diagonal elements are basically the eigenvalues of that particular matrix. I will write those points later once I am done with some examples, so that it will be, you will have the concrete notes of the notes on that. So since A is an upper triangular matrix, eigenvalues are its diagonal is principal diagonal elements. Okay, so lambda is equal to 3, minus 2 and 1 are the eigenvalues of this particular matrix. Now let's basically write down this particular equation is equal to 0 to find out the eigenvectors. If you solve for this, you get 3 minus lambda minus 2, 2, 0 minus 2 minus lambda, 1, and 0, 0, 1 minus lambda. X cap is equal to 0. Now let lambda is equal to minus 2. Let lambda is equal to minus 2, then we have 5 minus 2, 2, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 3. X1, X2, X3, this will be equal to 0, 0, 0. We can further reduce this third equation by R3. R3 minus 3R2. By doing this, we can get, so if we just do this, you get 5 minus 2, 2, 0, 0, 1, you get 0, 0, 0, x1, x2, and x3. Since there exists a linear dependency, we can see that third row is dependent on the first row by the factor 3, so it can be reduced to 0. And the rank of this matrix will never be 3. It will be less than 3. That is, in this case, is equal to 2. Okay. Nullity exists. Nullity is only 1. So we can say, we just write the basic information. Rank of this matrix is basically 2. Nullity is 1. Okay. So now let's open this thing up. You get 5x1 minus 2x2 plus 2x3 is equal to 0. We have x3 is equal to 0, okay? Since we are confirmed that x3 will always be equal to 0, we can take, let's say, x is equal to 2. Since rank is basically 2 in this case, so there are how many independent variables are there? Is n minus r. N minus r independent variables. N is 3 minus 2 is 1. So there will be one independent variable. So either of x1 take some value, or x2 can take some value. Let's say x2 is equal to k. Okay, let's say x2 is equal to k, then we will have, from here, we get 5x1 minus 2k plus 0 is equal to 0. So from here we can get x1 as 2 by 5k. Okay, x1 as 2 by 5k. So we have the eigenvector corresponding to lambda is equal to minus 2 of the form x1, x2, x3 is of the form 2 by 5k, k and 0, which is k times of 2 by 5, 1 and 0. And your k can take any value in R. Now, let's just have a look at the options. Can we get something from, can we get eigenvector from these two four options? I think we can get the D option, okay? If we just take, if k is equal to, if we take k as, with 2 by 2 comma 5 comma 0, yeah, if we just take k as 5, then we can get one of the eigenvectors as 2, because k will be 5, so 2 by 5 into 5 is 2, get 5 and 0, yeah. So option D is satisfying the answer, okay? So option D is basically your answer, D option. Let's have a look at another question. Let's have a look at this question. One pair of eigenvectors corresponding to the two eigenvalues of the matrix this is. So we have to choose one of these, one of the options given here. First of all, let's find out the eigenvalues is equal to 0. You get it as minus lambda minus 1, 1 minus lambda is equal to 0. And you get lambda square plus 1 is equal to 0. And you get lambda is equal to plus minus j. So there's a complex eigenvalue that you have now got. Now let lambda is equal to plus j. Okay, lambda is equal to plus j. Then your a minus lambda I x cap is equal to 0 equation will become minus I, or you can say minus j, since we're using j in this case, minus 1, 1 minus j into x1 and x2, 0 and 0. Okay, now from here, can we further reduce this thing up to a certain this thing? Okay, so we can basically apply R2. Basically, we can do J R2 plus R1. Can we do this thing? Yes, we can. J R2 plus R1 will be J square will be minus 1 minus of minus 1 will be plus 1. If we just make it, it will become 0. So what are we left with? This minus J minus 1, 0, 0. X1 and X2 is equal to 0, 0. So from here we can say that minus JX1 minus X1 minus JX1 plus minus X2 is equal to 0. And we don't know anything about X2 since one row has become 0 completely. Let's say X2 is equal to K. Okay. Let X2 is equal to K. So we get X1 as JK. Okay. So the X vector that we get is basically equal to x1 and x2, we get k times of j and 1. If k is minus j, we get another vector x2 as minus j, as plus 1 and minus j. So we can see that which of the options is basically satisfying this thing? So 1 minus j and j1. 1 minus j and j1. So satisfy this thing. So we have j1 and 1 minus j. So one of the options is basically, so okay. Now just so one, no option is basically satisfying this thing. Let's move on to another eigenvalue. So let lambda is equal to minus j. So corresponding to this, we get j minus 1, 1 j x1 x2 0 0. Okay. So if you solve for this, you get j x1 minus x2 is equal to 0 and x1 plus j x2 is equal to 0. So from the options, we can say that x1, x2, j minus 1 and 1j satisfy. okay, j minus 1 and j minus 1 and 1j, j minus 1 and 1j. So from here we can say that the option, so we have basically option A and D satisfying the answer. Okay, so we can see that corresponding to one eigenvector, it is 1 minus j, which we can see here, it is 1 minus j, and another one being j minus 1, which we get here, j minus 1, another being 1j and another being 1j and j1. So both the options basically satisfy. So it's basically seldom that more than one option is correct in the examination. So you won't encounter, it's basically very, very rare. So you get, so you don't need to confuse it. You can basically in this, you can just select any of the two options. Okay, understood. Let's have a look at this question. Consider a 2 cross 2 matrix A, sigma x, omega sigma, where x is unknown and the eigenvalues of matrix A are sigma plus j omega and sigma minus j omega, then x is equal to what? So now this option is correct. Since we have the matrix sigma x omega sigma, so we know if the eigenvalues of A are this, so we know basically the eigenvalues of the matrix A are these and this, this and this. So we know that the trace of a matrix is sigma plus sigma is the sum of the principal diagonal elements. It will be equal to 2 sigma. The trace of the matrix is also equal to the sum of eigenvalues. Okay. The trace of this matrix is also equal to the sum of the eigenvalues. Okay. So from here we can say sigma plus j omega plus sigma minus j omega will be equal to 2 sigma. This will cancel, so what we are left with is 2 sigma, okay, which is satisfied here as you can see. Now determinant of this matrix A, which is sigma square minus omega x, sigma square minus omega x, is equal to the product of the eigenvalues. So we can say that it will be equal to sigma plus j omega into sigma minus j omega, which is nothing but equal to sigma square plus omega square. So if x is equal to minus omega, then this equation will be satisfied. So answer will be equal to D, will be D. So option D is the answer. Okay. Okay, folks, I'm stopping this lecture here. This lecture was a bit introductory to eigenvalues and eigenvectors. We have to do some more things in the eigenvalues and eigenvector topic. Till then, solve the questions. Not many questions. I'm not basically advising you to solve many questions with in reference to this particular lecture. In the next lecture, I will start off with some more properties related to eigenvectors and eigenvalues, which can take almost half a lecture, So I will not be able to complete that thing in this particular lecture. If I basically try to do it, I will have to end it. I will have to stop those things in between, and that will certainly break the seamlessness in the lecture that I do not want. So I will continue in the next lecture. Till then, try to understand each and every concept that I have covered in this lecture and in the last three lectures. If you have any doubt, please get back to us and write on the comments below in the comment section. We will definitely and surely get back to you with the doubts. Do not hesitate to write down your doubts. It can be of any level, medium to high, or low, medium or high. High level doubt, complex doubt, simple doubt, we do not care. We just want them to be solved. We will definitely take care of your doubts. Thank you very much.